Hello guys, Luke Hodge here. Today we're finding out if the iPod Touch 5th generation is obsolete and if it's still useful today's modern day technology. Let's find out. Guys, straight into the iPod 5th generation. As you see, we've got the old FaceTime logo. As standard, it has not changed whatsoever. There's still Hangouts, still downloading. Now, before you say anything, there is not a lot of apps. The reason is all this time it's been running under my mum's Apple ID because at the time I did not have an email address or anything, or even didn't have this YouTube channel. And some reason my mum bought it from a place and it was already pre-set up under her bank account details and her account. And then just recently, a couple of days ago, I have reset it and put it under my thingy, under my name and stuff. And I've put download Google and YouTube and my airport utility to control my Apple router that's extending the range of the network at the moment. I'm going to be changing that. I'm going to, at some time, to make it my private phone, I'm going to buy some power line adapters. Seems I really wanted a private network, but I found you could get the network and change it and bit like that. But at this time, I couldn't. So that's how that is. Sorry, guys, for the unboxing videos. I've been trying to put the Airport Express one on, but it's been a pretty darn fiddle to try and get it all sorted, but in all cases, watch out for that one. But it will not have the intro in, since it's not synced up with my iPad. I've been doing most videos through my iPad, but anyway, let's get straight to it. First of all, photos do work fine. There's barely no photos on this, pretty much, because this has been reset and I have not basically had a lot of photos on it. But basic apps, you can get older versions. Like, for example, YouTube works fine as soon as you log in. Sometimes it can be a bit crashy with the service, but when you're using it, it works perfectly fine. Let it load up and you can be perfectly fine. Sign into your account. I haven't done that yet with my iPod yet, but I've done it with my main setup. I did have it logged in here, but when I resetted it, it's all reset. It done a hard reset piece of thing, and yeah. As you see, it's nice to have the air display. I have movies here. I've got no, for some reason it hasn't backed up that much. It's still very unreliable. It even won't find my music I've already bought. This is how so old this iPod is and how I've not been using it. I can only download stuff from USB because the contact I bought, they're asking me to pay for again. And that does nothing with any newer device I have now. That's why, how old this system still is. And why it's not supporting the rest of our device, because I haven't bought it from here. And why it's not working. But uploading stuff from USB works perfectly fine. As I'll demonstrate, I'll put Teenage These Days on, for example. Just for testing. Oh, I can see the music works perfectly fine. As you see, it supports AirPlay still, and even with the new updates, it still supports my AirPlay Express. I cannot do this at the moment since I haven't got my speakers connected to the power, so it won't do anything. But if I press them, it does work, so I guarantee it does work. So I've got, that's a test. The speakers still work fine on this this iPad, but it'll be fine on the other one. It depends what condition it is. So music works fine, and it still has the option you can do now. You can leave the music page and do whatever you want. You go on Facebook, but I haven't downloaded Facebook on this because I haven't had so much time. I found out though that I don't know if it would do with any others, but my homebrew's sort of gone a bit faulty, or it's just crashing because it's not compatible or something. But yeah, if I just quickly turn that music off. So it's very functional. I can go to the next song, it's very similar like the rest of it. But yeah, the music app works fine. Photos, taking a photo is not a big deal. It still works fine as normal. As we'll take, if we swap the camera around. As you see, I could take a photo of myself and the iPad. As you see, I'm videoing my iPad. I still, unless there's a Sony camera, I'm not sure because it's still pretty expensive. But if I take a temporary photo, if I just move it away. Photos take pretty instant and work perfectly fine, as you can see. Let me just go into the photo I just took. Okay, the lights haven't gone out. Something's gone a little bit faulty with this iPod. Okay, something's gone wrong with the camera. But anyway, let me take in that photo. As you see there, that's the photo. Very good quality still, and still works perfectly. As you see, there's a reflection of my light. But as you see there, that photo is still crisp and fully working great. As you see, if I go back to camera, everything works fine and it's still pretty good camera. If we go out of camera, clock still works fine. YouTube has no problem whatsoever, so I'm not doing copyrights or anything. I'll just play one of my videos, just in case anyone complains about it and basically makes a right old mess about it, but no argues and crap like that. I know Dan won't mind. Let me put Dan Bold in. Dan. Oh goodness, it's gone in capitals. Dan. Bold. You see, I'll search for that. Go to, oh, there it is. 96 videos, 25 subscribers, same as me, but it may have changed the time you watch this video and on probably on Dan's channel. Whoopsie. Didn't click on the right one. There you go. Dan Bold, here you go, he's fully prepped up with stuff. As you see, there's loads of things. It's recently been his birthday, but the time you watch this video again, as I said, it may be different. But the app works fine. Let me just go old iPad preview, for example, here. It can sometimes be a little bit crashy, as you see, I was trying to move it.
To review my old iPad, which is here.
Is it's not an iPad? But it'll get a load of comments. Let's see if anyone has commented on that. No comments. But anyway, YouTube works fine, apart from all of that. Google web searching still works fine, but years and years goes past, it could get worse. But this is 2015, this video was taken and it's working fine. It's still, and these are still, even new, they're still worth a bit of money. FaceTime, I have tried it, but for some reason it keeps logging me out, but it's only an 8GB model and it's, but it was working fine before and everything was fine. iTunes is a mixed bag, seems it hasn't updated, and the music app, even if you signed up to Apple Music, they still haven't updated this one. So if you got an iPod and you still use it, let's say for willing sake, or you do something with it, you can still not be able to use Apple Music because it hasn't got the new Apple Music application sign. You see, it's still the old one, but as you see, the police still saying messaging does work fine, but it does the same thing. But apart from that, everything works great. Apart from that, but I suppose that's it for the iPod. There isn't a lot to say about it because there isn't a lot of apps. But Facebook, when it was still on the same software, it's still running. Facebook still works great as normal. And yeah, this iPod has never failed me, except the memory compatibility was pretty goddamn rubbish. But yeah, I still use it for my docking station though, but everything apart from that works great on this iPod, and it's never let me down. Of course, the memory of it being an 8GB model, and of course, even my 32GB model comparison on the side, and you see this thing's bag load of apps. If I bring this against the size, the iPod fifth generation has got a different thing of it being bigger. As you see, the old music sign is, see, they haven't updated the music app. As you see on this one, it has updated the music app. Sorry, it's on some random music I've got right here. Let's, as you see, it's still got the old sign, and it's still not. It's just so out of date, and they should have done that with the old version, but they have not updated it, and there's a reason. And they will not update this one, and I think this is the last date update they've ever done. So this iPod's pretty much rubbish. But this one, though, this one's still being updated, even when the sixth generation is out. But this is still, but this though, on the other side hand, is still a very compatible device, especially if you just want to watch movies with. If you don't play any music and stuff, this is a great device for you, for web search and stuff. But if you're more extreme, get rid of this and upgrade to an iPod's 5th generation or newer. Excuse me. But anyway, apart from that, this iPod particularly works fine. Except the only thing, again, is Siri. You can only ask what the time is. What is the time?
The music is playing.
Sometimes it can miss her, but the new Siri, as I'll demonstrate on the iPod Touch, works fine. What is the time?
The time is 21:04.
As you see, it's very accurate. But anyway, guys, this iPod's still available to buy off Amazon. They've still got loads and they haven't sold yet. And there's also a load of the fifth generation are going for cheap money. So if you want to still get a modern one that still works with the Apple services, more like this one, this is pretty darn, and it's only, and the one still studying for this is iOS 6.1.1 or something. Well, like this, it's still running iOS 9, but I'm going to do a video of installing iOS 9, surprisingly or not. I've just recently signed up to better.apple.com, and you can be a member of them too. If you want to be, you can test out, if you're an iMac, you can, if you've heard it, you can test out the news and help Apple improve their software running testing out their products, even when it hasn't really came out to the public yet. But you are basically the testers, even when it's available to the public but it isn't available, and if you know the website, as I just said, better.apple.com, and it's a very compatible device, and you get to try out iOS Captain, iOS X sort of thing, and of course the very popular coming up iOS 9, available for iPod, iPad, iPhone, as everyone knows. But apart from that, this is a very compatible from the other one. This is still a little bit obsolete, but if you want to get an iPod, I recommend the iPod 5 generation. But in all cases, they both of them are very good devices still, but except this one is a little bit older and doesn't work that great to modern day. But this one that is still good. But if you still want a basic iPod, this is the way to go. But anyway, guys, this video is getting quite long, but as again, if you want to watch out for more updates and more tech stuff, especially like this iPod, and if you want to get a closer look and quicker look of you experiencing iOS 9 even when the release date is in autumn 2015, if you want to experience the new life, keep a watch out on my channel to how to install iOS 9 quicker on my channel. But as always, guys, Luke Hodges gotta go. But anyway, please comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye. One of my things is just subscribe, because it really helps me out, just to let you know about that. If you haven't subscribed and you haven't got a good account, create a Google account and you really help me out. But anyway, I gotta go, so see you guys. Please comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.